Welcome to Saturday Big 12 basketball from Gallagher-Iba Arena in Stillwater, Oklahoma, as the Kansas State Wildcats visit the Oklahoma State Cowboys. Along with former ACC head coach Dino Gaudio, I'm Mark Neely. All eyes, Dino, appropriately, will be on Oklahoma-Kansas later today. But that's a Kansas team that's lost the last 3 years here in Stillwater.
Mark, when these two teams score the ball, they could beat anyone in the country. The Cowboys shoot 50% from the field, make 11 threes in taking down number three, Kansas. Juwan Evans led the way with 22. And when Kansas State took down number one Oklahoma a week ago, their defense held Oklahoma to its fewest points, their lowest field goal percentage on the season, while putting up 80 points themselves. These are two of the best defensive teams in the country. When they score the ball, they're outstanding.
Dean Wade had 17 points off the bench in that game against OU. He'd come off the bench as well against Baylor, but he's back in the starting lineup today. And for the Cowboys, no Juwan Evans for the third consecutive game, so Griffin gets the start. Jeff Newberry, the only Cowboy to start every game so far this year. Cowboys still breaking the huddle as you see the Wildcats ready for the tip. They're in their road purple today. Oklahoma State in the home white. And Bruce Weber in his fourth season. Really a reconstruction this year, Dino. A very young team this year.
One of the youngest teams in the country. What do they have? Like seven freshmen on this roster. So, but you know what they do, Mark? They really defend.
And Travis Fort now in his eighth season here in Stillwater. And we're ready to go. Our officiating crew, Mike Stewart, Darren George, Bert Smith, Brent Smith, that is. We're underway, and the Cowboys have the first possession.
Now, Kansas State is physical with their defense. They push your offense out from the attack area. Let's see how Oklahoma State handles it without Juwan Evans.
A look from Carroll back out front. That's a three on the way, around and out after the miss by Hammonds. Brown launches. Big board by Carroll.
Boy, quick shot for Kansas State early in the shot clock.
Hammonds takes another three from the corner, and that is off the mark. Some quick shots already in this game.
Well, you're thinking Kansas State needs to develop the inside, their inside game, like they did against Baylor on Wednesday night.
Trying to punch it inside to Hammonds, deflected, and a foul will be called. That's Kansas State. It was against Corby Irvin, his first.
Oklahoma State, a team fighting attrition. They lost their starting point guard, Juwan Evans. He gets 42 against Oklahoma, and then they lost Phil Forte. I called that game, Mark, down at the Charleston Classic, who's probably a kid that would be getting 18 a game by now, Forte.
And Phil Forte hurt in game three of the season.
When I called the game, he got on the floor for a loose ball. He does all the little things, and someone just rolled on his shoulder. It's hard to believe he's been gone all this time.
So that's the way the scoring begins. Is the three for Carroll. Forte on the bench. An elbow injury. He had started 102 consecutive games before that injury has cost him his season. One dude trying to get around Mitchell Salomon. We call for the block.
Phil Forte has scored over 1,300 points in his career. And coming into his final season, you're thinking he's probably getting, I know it says 13 up there, 12-8, but probably getting 18 a game by now.
And an offensive foul. There to take the charge was Tyree Griffin.
And, Mark, I really think Travis Ford has done a great job with this team. He has them in every game, five of their league losses by five or fewer points. And they're tied with Baylor and Iowa State in the final 2 minutes of those games.
Wondu picked up the foul for K-State. You're inside the first 2 minutes. Carroll has the three for the only point so far.
Now, when we talked to Travis Ford yesterday, he said he was going to tweak his offense a little bit. Predominantly this season, they've been ball screen. We haven't seen many ball screens early in this one by
Tough
Oklahoma
shot.
State.
Hammonds, the fadeaway. And there's the steal. Newberry. Already three Kansas State turnovers.
Yeah, and that's been a problem. When they struggled, they turned the ball over much too often.
Foul on the floor.
I mean, that's just an unforced stand. You can't make that across the court pass 35 feet without seeing the defense.
And the easy stuff for Newberry. Oklahoma State trying to get a little payback on K-State. These teams play back on January 23rd in Manhattan. And as Travis Ford said to us yesterday, they were outplayed in just about every facet, losing 89-73 up in Manhattan.
Now we've missed some jump shots. I try to take the ball inside. Pick and roll with DJ Johnson.
Spin in the lane. A one-two gives it up. And there's DJ Johnson for the lay-in. He has been a bigger scoring force in recent games for the Wildcats.
That's where they got to go early with the ball. DJ Johnson coming off a 19.5 offensive rebound game against Baylor.
And those 19 points, a career high for DJ. Played 32 minutes and somebody fell asleep on Newberry, who lays it in.
And a wonderful back screen by Oklahoma State. Kansas State, the guy guarding the screener, Mark, has to help on that flex cut.
Barry Brown steps up, shoots the long two, and nails it. That's the freshman Barry Brown out of St. Petersburg, Florida.
And he needed it. He's been struggling. 0 for 7 from threes the last two games, 6 for 21 from the field. What I liked about Barry Brown there, shot fake 3-2, the pull-up went down for him.
Doubled on the baseline. Solomon. Foul called on the floor for the drive to the bucket by Solomon.
Kansas State is really physical with their defense. They go right up to the line without crossing it with the advent of the new rules. But this is a good defensive team because they're physical with their defense.
Dean Wade picked up the foul. He goes out. Got Austin Butke now in the game. Turnaround jumper, and Leighton Hammonds hits down one to make it 4 minutes into the game, a five-point lead.
Double figures in five straight games for Hammonds. He's played well in the latter five for the Cowboys.
A one-two stripped from behind by Newberry. Griffin from the corner. There for Hammonds, but an offensive rebound for Solomon. Another three. And out with it comes Brown.
Kansas State on the road. Points are tough to come by. Keep going inside.
K-State missed their first two shots, hit their last two, but there's a steal in the entry pass intended for DJ Johnson. Grabbed by Hammonds, and Solomon lays it in. Taking advantage of what already is the fifth Kansas State turnover in under 5 minutes.
And that's the story of the game thus far. Oklahoma State runouts off Kansas State turnovers, ill-advised passes, some unforced there. The last one right there, pass the ball not to the post guy, Mark. Throw it away from the defense.
Timeout used by Kansas State. Under 5 minutes gone in Stillwater. Solomon with the finish. That's a seven-point lead.
Behind the three-point line, both season highs, and Kansas State's 89 points, the most Oklahoma State had given up this year.
Yeah, and the next most they've allowed in a game, Oklahoma State, is 79, so that was a significant scoring game for K-State. As you mentioned, they're great shooting in that one. All five starters scored in double figures for K-State in that win over Oklahoma State earlier this season.
Well, what we've seen early in this one here is the exact opposite. Kansas State not taking care of the ball. This is usually a good execution basketball team, Kansas State, with ball movement, a lot of good screening. Mark, to be good on offense against man-to-man, you have to have a screening game and an inside game. Kansas State unable to do that because they're giving the ball away to Oklahoma State.
And they've turned it over five times in nine total possessions prior to this one. That's a three from Wade. It's short. Rebounded. Going up with it, Edwards. And the third chance, the tip in by Stephen Hurt.
When you're struggling to score, the easy baskets get you over the hump. Second shots are one way to get them.
Hurd had 11 points in 15 minutes a week ago on Saturday against Oklahoma. Stephen Hurd, a guy that Bruce Weber told us a couple of days ago he wants to get more out of offensively. Rebound by Brown. Owundu trying to beat Hurt with a dangerous pass, and Olivier reached around, thought he had a good defensive play, but the foul is whistled.
One of the things DJ Johnson needs to do, when that defender has his arm across your body, break his arm down or up. Get that hand out of the passing lane right here. Duck in, I like it. The reach over by Olivier, but if you're DJ Johnson, get his arm out of the passing lane.
Third team foul against Oklahoma State, and Hurt may have gotten poked. He wears the goggles.
I think he got hit in the chin. Come on, a big fella got to have a tougher chin in that one, right? If
yeah,
that's what happened.
He's a 6'11", 265-pounder. Oh, whacked him right on the side of the face. Hammonds did. Trying to fight through a screen.
Give him a standing eight count. Wipe his gloves off. Get him back in there.
Hurt, whose nickname is Big Hurt. And I don't think that's because most he reminds people of Frank Thomas, the baseball player, Hall of Famer. Owundu. Off the mark from Justin Edwards.
Now, when we talked to Travis Ford yesterday, he talked about, without Juwan Evans, tweaking his offense, going away from all the ball screen action, which Evans was excellent in. A lot more movement, a lot of back screen action. Flex right now for Oklahoma State.
And speaking of Juwan Evans, they've not come out with anything official on his health. Here's a three, knocked down by Tavares Shine coming in off the bench for Oklahoma State.
Another guy that played well when they beat Kansas. He played 24 minutes in that game, Shine. 8 points. Two big back-to-back threes.
A long two from Hurt. Here's Newberry. Hammond swings it around. Gets it back into the corner. And a travel committed by Newberry. But that's just the first Oklahoma State turnover of the game compared with the five early ones from K-State.
And you know what? If I'm Travis Ford, I'm not happy with the turnover, but I like the possession because, boy, they threw the drift pass along the baseline. They made one more to dribble penetration and a kick out. Oklahoma State executing their way on offense instead of trying to shoot their way through problems.
Griffin taking a seat. Five different Cowboys have scored already in this game. They lead it by eight. Wade sealed off by Solomon. An illegal pick on the moving screen on Corby Urban. That's his second. It comes at the 12:34 mark.
And another turnover for Kansas State.
So make it six now so far.
At least the dead ball turnovers don't hurt you as much as the live ball. So on that turnover, Oklahoma State has to inbound the ball. Gives Kansas State a chance to set up their defense.
Six turnovers and 12 possessions for the Wildcats. You saw Brian Rowletter down in the game, number 33. He has the defense on Newberry. Down low on the baseline, Sean fouled.
And Mark, when Oklahoma State changes its defense, when they first lost Juwan Evans, they didn't have any practice time. They couldn't tweak anything. So Travis Ford told us he gave him a day off, had two practice days where he could put in a new system without Evans, give those guys two practice days to get used to it, a shoot around today. And to be honest, they're executing pretty well in a half court offensively.
Second foul on Dean Wade on that previous play, so he comes out. Now Mitchell Solomon to the bench for the Cowboys. Yeah, Butke in the game now for K-State. Joe Burton in for the Cowboys. A handoff to Jeffrey Carroll. Carroll driving, runs into Johnson. It's out of bounds. Last touched by Johnson, they say. It'll stay with Oklahoma State. And eight on the shot clock. Timeout. Under 12 minutes to go, first half. The spin by Griffin. And the three knocked down by Shine. Time on ESPN. Buddy Hield averaging about 26 points per game. Second in the nation. Got us thinking about the Big 12 and the players that have averaged 25-plus points, 5-plus rebounds per game. It takes us to Kevin Durant, who was the AP National Player of the Year in 97, who was at 26 and 11, had 11 30-point games that year. From Kansas State, Michael Beasley back in the 07-08 season, 26 and 12, and had 13 30-plus games. And a look at Buddy's numbers so far this year.
Wow, and he's made dramatic shots coupled with the season that he's having in general. We know the 46 points against Kansas in game one, but and both of his predecessors we threw up there, Mark, both second picks in the draft. Durant second to Greg Oden that year. Derrick Rose was the number one pick when Michael Beasley came out. It'll be interesting in that one because Oklahoma right now, their three-point shooting has cooled off the past three games, only 34%. So if they're to beat Kansas at home, they're going to have to shoot the ball better from behind the line.
Speaking of shooting it from behind the line, Burton with a three, and it's an 11-point lead for the Cowboys.
Well, that's a scouting report shot. We know more than half of his shots are from behind the three-point line. When he catches, chase him off the line, make him bounce it.
Johnson looking. A 1-2 in the lane with the left hand. Cannot finish. And the steal, a 1-2 right next to the official. Then he passes. And coming back was Burton, or Griffin actually, defensively, to prevent the lay-in.
I like the play by Iwandu because when you're struggling to score, that's an energy and effort play. Those hustle plays make the difference for you. Now let's see if they can go to the line and finish the free throw. Our first free throws on the afternoon so far.
B.J. Johnson, 63% foul shooter this year. Barry Brown returns for the Wildcats, replacing a 1-2 who came in leading the team and scoring at 13 points per game. And he is 0 for 2 so far from the field. Got them both. That last one took a little spin off the heel. Griffin playing that spot with Juwan Evans out for a third consecutive game. And they get the steal thanks to Brown and Johnson.
Well, you see why Travis Ford has gone away from ball screen action. Not as good as Juwan Evans coming off those ball screens.
Edwards taken away by Oklahoma State.
And terrific help defense by Oklahoma State.
Shine, who had that help defense, shoots a three, and he hits his second of the afternoon. Good start for the Cowboys from beyond the arc. Getting four of their first eight. Rolletter has not shot much this year in his action. Only attempted three shots from the field all year.
Mark, when those guards come off those ball screens, they got to run their defender into the screen.
Johnson gets it before time expires. To a 10-point game as we slip under the 10-minute mark.
A lot more screening off the ball for Oklahoma State.
Seven to shoot. Griffin. Brown and Butke giving chase. There's the block by Edwards. That would... would have gone, but it hit the front of the rim and then it was tipped and the shot clock expired.
But what a great defensive possession by Kansas State. They guarded the entire thing, and then it was wonderful ball screen defense. Closing out on a rotation from the help side, that's terrific defense. That's why Kansas State. Mark, we talked about this. The 10 of their 10 losses, all of them to teams in the top 25.
Yeah, really incredible. It says a lot about the conference in general, because obviously most of that is coming conference play, but none of those 10 losses has come to a team outside the AP top 25.
Seven of those losses against teams in the top 15.
Three short from Edwards on the run out. Here's Newberry to the hoop. Johnson makes it a one and done, and out comes a one two behind the back. Shoots a three, got it. First one knocked down today by Wesson Wundu.
And that's Kansas State basketball. Their defense, the last two times, terrific stops leading to offense.
Griffin, a dangerous pass, but able to find Shine. There's a three, Newberry. In and out. Solomon went after it, but it's back to Newberry, who finds Griffin in the corner. Wundu with a three on the last trip for the Wildcats. Gets in the lane this time and kicks to the corner. This three comes from Brown. Back-to-back threes last two trips for the Kansas State Wildcats.
And I'm surprised Brown was able to hit it, Mark, because it wasn't a great pass. He picked it right off of his shoe tops, gathered himself, and put it down. But Owandu getting in the lane collapses the Oklahoma State defense, which creates the avenue for the pass.
Oklahoma State was leading it by 12. Now an 8-0 run for K-State. And Edwards crashes into Shine and commits the foul. But Kansas State has gotten right back in this game, Dino.
They really have. And the big difference is that from behind a three-point line, Owandu dribbles right into it. And then the dribble penetration collapses your defense. Not a great pass, but a pretty good shot.
Keep it real, keep players. There is nothing finer than Duke Carolina.
Dino, of course, you coached in the ACC, and I know the other teams that aren't Duke or North Carolina probably get a little resentful of that rivalry, but it is a darn good one.
No question. It's the best rivalry, I think, in college basketball. And both of these teams this season, really high-scoring teams. And Mark, both of these teams in my backyard, I think Duke, they're talking about their struggles. The reason they are where they are is because Krzyzewski on the bench. Because they don't have a true point guard. They don't have a guy they could throw the ball to on the blocks. And I just think Mike's doing a terrific job with this team.
Duke, Virginia, 4:30 Eastern today on ESPN. The turnover story in this one is completely turned around. Oklahoma State didn't turn it over in their first 11 possessions, and now they've turned it over five times in their last nine. Meanwhile, K-State, which turned it over half of their first 12 possessions, 6 of 12, have not turned it over in their last seven.
That's the story of the game, Kansas State's turnovers early. And we're looking at Kansas State defense. They're in gaps. They stop dribble penetration. That's why this team is so good on the defensive end of the floor.
It's an 8-0 run right now for Kansas State as they were down 12 at 20-8. Out of bounds, staying with the Wildcats.
Mark, the hardest thing to do in our game today is guard the ball one-on-one, especially with the new rules. So you have to have good help side defense, and Kansas State has that.
I'm talking with Bruce Weber. This is such a young team. He's been very pleased how well they've picked up the defense that they require to play at K-State with so many young players.
Well, I think given their talent, Kansas State, this is as well a coached team as there is in the country, especially on the defensive end of the floor.
Griffin trying to break the drought for the Cowboys. That's a three off the right side from Newberry, but kept alive.
Again, another good defensive possession, especially at the end of the clock. Ball screen defense. But Kansas State has to wrap up the possession with the rebound.
K Cowboys have missed their last five from the field. From Gallagher Iba Arena, we call basketball on this Saturday. K-State, Oklahoma State. Along with Dino Gaudio, I'm Mark Neely. Shot clock at five. Newberry's going to have to do something with it. That'll be a three. Got it!
You know what? Good defense, a little better offense right there.
Newberry, 7 points, his first three of the game. Yes, four rebounds as well.
Boy, he's an undersized wing. He's a bulldog, that kid. Now, his whole career, he was a point guard. And without Evans in there, he gives them another handler on the offensive end of the floor.
Boy, Solomon with the block and takeaway, allowing the offensive opportunity for Griffin, who's fouled.
Another really good defensive possession by Kansas State. And terrific contest as well. We would tell guys, Mark, make them miss. Don't hope they miss. That was pretty good defense right there, but a better shot by Jeff Newberry.
First visit to the line today for the Cowboys. Here comes for Tyree Griffin, who gets the friendly roll. Hurd comes back. Austin Budke back in for Kansas State.
Griffin, a strong, quick, really fast with the basketball. And what I really like about him, he is an in-your-face defender on the ball. He really applies pressure defensively, Tyree Griffin.
Seven different scores now in this first half for Oklahoma State. They lead it by eight. Budke trying to feed Hurt. Solomon saves it. Fires it into Hammett. Now up ahead. Griffin giving Newberry an opportunity and the three from Hammonds.
You know what? That was a wonderful defensive play by Mitchell Solomon.
Brown comes crashing in. The offensive foul with Newberry taking the charge.
What I like about Oklahoma State's post defense, they play the guy before he catches the basketball. Tough to drive on both these teams, Mark. Their guys are in gaps. They're making you kick and shoot jump shots.
That's going to bring Anthony Allen, the seven-footer, off the bench for Oklahoma State here under 5 minutes to go in the first half. Solomon has taken a seat. Oklahoma State's allowing just over 66 points per game, number two in the conference. The issue for Oklahoma State is they've only been averaging about 69 points per game. Take away a one-two, feeding Edwards in transition. But he traveled, no bucket.
I don't know. Did you see a walk on that one?
I did not.
I thought it was a nice pass in the open court. The best way to advance the ball is not with the dribble, with the pass, but I think so. They got it right.
Trying the, is that a Euro step?
They tried the double jump stop, and then, now you can pick your pivot foot up, but you can't put it back down.
So the travel to ninth for K-State, the turnover that is.
That little bunny hop toss.
Rolls out of bounds off Oklahoma State's Jeffrey Carroll.
And we've seen two turnovers by Oklahoma State just on the ball because Kansas State is so into the dribbler. Really good ball pressure by K-State.
Grabbing the foul on Griffin. Under 4 minutes to go in the first half. And Oklahoma State on top of K-State, 24-16. Consecutive game. Great point guard. One that reminds me of one player used to coach, in Chris Paul.
Absolutely. You know why, Mark? Because he's really good at getting into the lane. And I think he has a special knack for seeing the passes, the dimes. But he's a really good ball screen point guard. And one of the things that made Chris Paul special, He did what the game told him to do. In other words, he didn't make his mind up ahead of time. Like, hey, if I throw three lobs to Blake Griffin, it's my turn next time. No, he read the defense, did what the defense told him to do. And that's what I think Juwan Evans does. And what a terrific young talent that this kid had. 42 against Oklahoma, 22, 8 assists against Kansas. A special young guy right there.
Out with a shoulder injury, and unfortunately the prognosis not good for the remainder of the season, but nothing official has come out from Oklahoma State on that. This is his third consecutive game here today. Hammonds. Shine hit his first couple of three-point attempts today, but that went a little long.
And that's what I said earlier. I think Travis Ford has these guys in every game. They're playing really well, and they don't have their two best players. Evans doesn't play. Phil Forte isn't in the game, obviously.
Pass was a little behind Butke, and a turnover. And suddenly, after that 8-0 run for K-State, they've turned it over five straight times.
Yeah, Butke got to see that ball. Catch it with your eyes. In other words, watch it go into your hands. How about Austin Butke, chemical engineering major, came from Gene Cady's hometown in Beloit, Kansas. The connection with Coach Cady and the staff at Kansas State.
Timeout, 3:20 to play as the Cowboys burn one here in the first half. .320 to go. That was an Oklahoma State timeout. The reason I was questioning it, because I tell you what, Bruce Weber was a little upset at his troops.
Absolutely. Sometimes it's not about the X's and the O's. It's about energy and emotion, and that's what he's employing to get out of his guys. And when you're on the road, Mark, you have to play really hard to even have a chance.
Griffin is fouled.
Butke. When you show on those ball screens, you can't let the dribbler get to your body. In other words, it's almost like you're playing tag with somebody. Don't let him touch you when you show on those ball screens.
First down Butke, but it is the 10th team foul against Kansas State here in the first half. So two shots. First one missed by Griffin, who's an outstanding free throw shooter. Best on the team at 85% on the year. Comes DJ Johnson returning for the Wildcats. Tyree Griffin hit his first 13 free throws of the season. And he misses both. But who touched that? They're going to say it's off Oklahoma State. K-State ball.
Well, we knew these are two good defensive teams, and this would be a defensive struggle, and that's exactly what we've seen in the first 17 minutes of this one.
Just 3 points for a one-do so far. He's hit a three, 1-for-4 overall from the field. Here is a one-do. Screen from Hurts. Dangerous pass, a good one, though, and Edwards unable to finish, but is fouled. Second one on Mitchell Solomon. That's Weber during the last timeout trying to get his team, shall we say, a little more in tune with what's going on.
To be honest with you, he went so hard at Barry Brown. I think he was happy with what Brown did on the floor over there. Hugging him up a little bit. And he's telling these other guys, we need more of that out of you guys as well.
Free throws from Justin Edwards.
Boy, you have to have a certain psychology dealing with 18 to 22-year-olds. That's what coaching's all about.
You know, we were watching the Kentucky game, Kentucky-South Carolina, before we took air, and Coach Cal got thrown out of the Kentucky game early today.
First 4 minutes of that one, he was gone. Doug Sermon's tossed him.
The big guy Allen here, tied up by DJ Johnson. Possession arrow gives it to K-State.
Yeah, big guys need room to operate on the interior, and the best thing that they could have done right there, Anthony Allen, is post a little deeper in the lane, catch the ball where you could score from.
Travis Ford, in our conversations about Anthony with him, he said, you know, Allen, with his size, he can be a bit of an X factor for us.
Right, because he's a rim protector. He provides shot blocking with the cop for Oklahoma State.
Coming up on the two-minute mark, K-State trailed by as many as a dozen. That's a two that's short from a one-two, but in the right spot, Edwards thought maybe he waited too long, but he didn't. He timed it perfectly and lays it in.
Terrific patience and poise from Edwards on the off, after the offensive rebound.
Down to a four-point game.
Now, like we talked with Travis yesterday, where do you go to for point productivity if you're Oklahoma State?
3 seconds.
3 seconds.
This is that last sequence. Watch Edwards here.
Well, he's their leading shot attempter. And one of the reasons why is he does his work also at the cup, at the rim. Good offensive rebound. I love the shot fake. Really patience and poise from the senior when he had it down low.
He had 19 points off the bench against Baylor on Wednesday night. Fouled out for the first time this year in that game. Shine. Collision there with Griffin. He picks up his second.
You know what I like? When Oklahoma State made the switch and Allen was on the guard, they drove the big guy. A lot of guys settle for the jump shot, but they penetrated and then the kick out. Stephen Hurt,
76% foul shooter this year. Hurt, who uses the goggles except when he shoots free throws. And coming up next week, big Monday, North Carolina State taking on 7th-ranked Virginia at 7 in the ACC, and then we head to the Big 12. These Cowboys will be at Allen Fieldhouse playing 6th-ranked Kansas at 9 Eastern Time. All part of Rivalry Week presented by Wendy's and streaming live on Watch ESPN and the ESPN app.
Well, the Jayhawks will be waiting for payback when they come in the Fog Island, right?
Because they've not had success here in Stillwater in the last 3 years. In fact, Kansas has been beaten by Oklahoma State back in 2010 when they were number one, in 2013 when they were number one. They were ranked 5th and 14 when they lost. Last year they were ranked 8th when they lost here. And of course, had the high ranking here, number one, earlier in the year.
Mark, I just think Oklahoma's struggling from behind the three-point line. I'm going to beat them. I know I'm in a minority. I think Kansas goes in there and wins today.
Wow. That pass out of reach, and the turnover for Oklahoma State is their 10th. So the turnovers have just about evened out now. 11 for K-State, 10 for Oklahoma State. Coming up at the intermission, we'll send it to the studio with Chris Hassel and LaFonso Ellis. They'll preview what's up ahead for 7th-ranked Virginia and Duke, Wisconsin, Maryland, and a Big 12 matchup between Iowa State and Texas. How about Shaka Smart in Texas? They're streaking.
He got him going, heading in the right direction with a different style than he ran at VCU. No havoc right now at Texas. But pretty good wins.
Three, Brown off the back rim. Rebounded, Johnson had it for a moment, but taken back away by Leighton Hammonds. Shot clock off. Oklahoma State's turned it over, though, five times in their last seven possessions, and they can play for the final shot.
You want to take this with maybe six or five on the game clock, so do you have a chance for a second shot opportunity?
Put up with four, got it! Three from Leighton Hammonds. And it's a five-point lead for Oklahoma State. The 22 points for K-State at the intermission is a season low this year. But they're only down by five. Oklahoma State hits six threes in that first half and one with just 4 seconds remaining. We're going to send it to the studio at the other side of the break with Chris Hassel and LaFonso Ellis. It's Oklahoma State by five at the break. Getting ready for the start of the second half. Oklahoma State by five over Kansas State, 27-22. Both teams had bouts with turnover issues in the first half, but it was the ball movement of Oklahoma State in half number one that helped them open up a one-point, a 12-point lead.
Well, Travis Ford told us yesterday, without Juwan Evans, he was going to tweak his offense a little, fewer ball screens, more ball movement, And Oklahoma State did that in the first half. Screening off the ball, back screen leading the guys, the bigs popping out. And they're really sharing the ball, Mark. They took it without Juwan Evans and the ball not in his hands. Dribble penetration led to threes for them. They're making longer possessions on offense, which they're making Kansas State guard for a longer portion of the shot clock. And another long possession, but that's how Oklahoma State wants to play without their two best players, Forte and Evans out there. And you know what? They're executing the game plan with just 2 days of practice very, very well on the offensive end of the game.
Turnovers were a big issue early for K-State, more later in the first half for Oklahoma State with 21 combined turnovers. And you look at the free throws, K-State perfect. But the shooting, 42% for Oklahoma State, 35% for K-State.
And K-State in game one, when they won that one, they were shooting lights out. That's not the case today. Oklahoma State's defense a little tougher right now.
January 23rd at Manhattan, K-State won going away over Oklahoma State, 89-73. The 89 points, the most that Oklahoma State has allowed in a game this year. And the 57% field goal percentage, 52% three-point percentage, season highs for K-State, and it's been a different story today.
It really has, and there's no question, both of these coaches, when they went into halftime, the first thing they addressed was the turnovers. And Travis Ford also, like in the loss to TCU, 14 first half turnovers, 22 for the game. Now they have the lead right now, but ball security is a big key for both of these teams.
Well, if it seems like the half a little longer than normal, it's because the officials took a look at the Leighton Hammond's three at the end of the first half to make sure it was a three and not a two. That took a few minutes, so they didn't start the countdown clock until that was completed. So that's why halftime went a little bit longer than usual here. But we're off and running in half number two with Oklahoma State having possession.
See, you're seeing more screens away from the ball for Oklahoma State. Staggered doubles, a low away to try to get Mitchell Solomon to the block. And that's the little difference that Travis Ford has tried to create and tweak in his offense without Juwan Evans.
Like a tie up there, and it goes to K-State. Wade. One two in the first half. 3 points on 1 of 5 shooting. Wade short with the three. First shot of the game for Wade. That three is sunk by Leighton Hammonds, who had a three to win the first half for Oklahoma State.
Well, one of the reasons Kansas State is a good defensive team, Mark, is because their defense gets back and set, and they play 5-on-5. That wasn't the case right there. Poor transition defense for Kansas State.
Edwards driving. Now a one-two. Doubled, spins, shoots over. It was partially blocked, though, by Newberry. Hammonds ran into Wade, but traveled. With a 12th Oklahoma State turnover, and their second already here in the second half.
Well, when you got guys like Tyree Griffin on the ball and Jeff Newberry guarding Awandu, those one-on-one matchups, this is a team game, but it's played by individuals. You want to win your individual matchup.
Kicked, and that was off Awandu.
Yeah, you're seeing Kansas State, Mark, with a young team on the road. And when you have a young team, it's not making the great plays. It's eliminating the bad ones. The bad plays are what get you beat. And especially on the road, those things rear their head.
Corby Irvin, the second, replaces Wes Awandu. 22 points for K-State in the first half, a season low. They're scoreless through the first minute and a half of half number two.
And we know part of that was because of their 11 turnovers.
Punched out of the hand of Solomon by Johnson. Skip. Newberry drives. Lost it. And it's going to be tied up again. This time Oklahoma State has the possession arrow.
With 7 on the shot clock. So baseline out of bounds are important right here for Oklahoma State. Let's see if they can execute with 7 on the clock.
Catch and shoot, Newberry. Edwards among three Wildcats in the area coming down with a rebound.
Well, I like the play because Newberry's a guy that could create a shot for himself, has elevation on his jump shot to at least get it off.
Chance to reverse it there. Irvin hesitated on the baseline and then saw an opening. Just the second field goal made, though, for K-State in their last 15 possessions.
Well, for the point guard, the junior, you love the hesitation dribble. It froze the defense, and that's how he was able to get the ball to the other side of the rim.
Down to six to shoot. Newberry leans in. Griffin got the three off in time. The tip almost goes.
Sometimes, Mark, with a short clock, you give guys the ball in a position of weakness. That's exactly what happened right there. Shai didn't have time to even gather himself for the shot. And you're wondering why Kansas State's struggling to get the ball inside, because Oklahoma State fronts the post or three-quarter high side. They just don't allow the ball to go into the low post.
Edwards ran into the defender, Hammonds, but the outlet pass is too far for Tyree Griffin. And Edwards feeling the effects of that collision with Leighton Hammonds.
And that's why Oklahoma State struggled against TCU. 14 first half turnovers, 22 for the game. And really what was an unforced error right there.
Brown 5 points, 2 of 5. He's hit a three. Does have 4 rebounds. Wade giving a look for DJ Johnson, but it's kicked to the wing. Edwards leans, shoots off the right side, crashing the boards. Johnson.
Mark, when I was at Wake Forest, we played Florida State. They had great size in front of the post. And one of the ways to combat that offensively is feed the post from the top as opposed to the wing. Try to go high-low against that action.
Hammonds guarded by Wade. Spins from the short corner, Solomon.
But a good shot, because that's one of his strengths. He's a very good 15-foot jump shooter, Mitchell Solomon.
Three from Wade. Wade unable to find the scoring column so far today.
We talked about when these teams score the ball, they could beat anybody in the country. But we're having a knockdown, drag-out, grind-up game right here, because both of them pretty solid on the defensive end of the floor.
Hammonds three. Tip good. There's Jeffrey Carroll.
Usually a catch and shoot guy, but his productivity needs to be up now without Forte and without Juwan Evans. Jeff Carroll has to step up. One way to do it, offensive rebound for Oklahoma State.
Carroll had 10 points at TCU on Monday night. With 5 points now. Timeout.
Boy, when you're struggling to score, one way to get an easy basket is a second shot opportunity. Carroll has the size, the length, the strength. Finishes at the rim.
Over 5 minutes gone here in the second half. Oklahoma State leading it by 6. And Dino, interesting to watch what Oklahoma State's doing defensively. Let's go inside the play. Kind of a little pro move here.
Yeah, they're borrowing a step from the NBA where the big guy, 41, Mitchell Solomon, is near the baseline. So that's called downing the ball screen, forcing the dribbler, 14 in purple, down towards your help. But a little late on the rotation right here by Tyree Griffin. If he's a little earlier, that's a steal, that's a run out. And the NBA uses that, Mark, because they don't want those big guys out on the floor showing all ball screens. So they want to force the dribbler down towards the baseline.
Griffin, by the way, picked up his third foul on that play. He's the first player on either side to three fouls. But Kansas State turns it right back over.
Where you're seeing Oklahoma State reverse the ball from one side to the other. Make Kansas State go from ball side to help side defensively.
Three on the shot clock. Forcing one up, a long two from Hammonds. Kent State takes a moment, but got Budke rebounds. Didn't get another good shot. We've seen a lot of shots late in the clock.
We really have, and it's because of the defense, Mark. And what both of these teams need to do a little more of is try to get the ball in the lane off of the dribble. That's what collapses the defense.
Oklahoma State led by as many as 12 in the first half. K-State has never led in this game. Lean in. That's a travel whistled against Carroll.
But I think that's what they need to do more of. Take the ball into the lane, and I'm not sure. I was wrong on the first one, but I'm not sure if that's a travel either right there. But that's what both of these teams need to do, try to get the ball into the lane area.
So 14 Oklahoma State turnovers, 13 for K-State. What a quiet day so far for a Wundu with just 3 points. Came in as their leading scorer at 13 a game. But his kick to Edwards and a three.
And the kick is off of the ball screen action. They got the ball into the lane, drew the help, and created the avenue for the pass and a wonderful shot for the three for Kansas State.
K-State as close as they have been in a long while. Just a three-point advantage for Oklahoma State. Newberry stumbling, just threw it in the corner, and he was fortunate that he had a man there, but then Carroll falls down. Edwards has numbers and does find a 1-2, but the ball was blocked from behind by Shine, but a foul whistled against Oklahoma State. Foul on Olivier, number two.
Well, what we saw earlier, on the side you could down the ball screen, but at the top mark, they're not able to do that. The drive, the penetration. When you get the ball in the lane, nothing hurts your defense more than dribble penetration. And it created a three-point shot, and Kansas State needed that one badly.
K-State 3 of 11 now in three-point shooting. Oklahoma State's fared better at 7 of 19. Three here would tie the game. Hurt, Budke. Contact, no foul.
What a great find. And if you're Bruce Weber, you're really happy with the shot. You're not going to get a better shot at the cup than that right there.
Newberry spun down and fouled by Justin Edwards, his second personal.
Now, you're seeing one of the deficiencies in Austin Budke's game. He's not real athletic, has a difficult time scoring through bigs near the block.
The drive, Hammonds tip. No third chance, brought out by Edwards. He's on the run, kicks it back to Irvin. Irvin runs into Solomon. Call that on Mitchell Solomon.
I like Corby Irvin's decision making. He's only 3 for 22 from threes on the year, so he passed up the three and put the ball on the floor to take it to the rim.
Third on Solomon. He joins Griffin with three personals for Oklahoma State.
And Mitchell Solomon throughout the year has been in foul trouble, Mark. Four conference disqualifications and 11 games for Mitchell Solomon.
Down to a two-point game. Returning for the Cowboys, Griffin. For Jeffrey Carroll. Irvin sitting right at his season average per game.
Kansas State, not about outsmarting people. They're all about outworking people, and that's what Bruce Weber has brought to this program.
Cats a perfect 8 of 8 from the line. They're within one, 8 minutes into this second half.
You're seeing Kansas State switching those baseline cutter screens, the screens that are being set on the block.
Three from Hammonds.
Boy, he's a stretch four streaky shooter, but when he gets hot, in his last five games, 50% from the field, Leighton Hammonds.
He missed his first four threes, hit his fifth, which was the last shot of the first half. In the lane, Irvin in the crowd. Edwards three. He answers for K-State.
Now we're heating up a little bit. Both teams, good looks from behind a three-point line.
Points start to come at a little better flurry. For a while there, Dino, I thought first to 40 wins this one.
It was a grind, and going down the stretch, it'll probably be the same.
Fewest points in a game this year for Oklahoma State's 56. Fewest for K-State, 55. Going to have to put it up. Another shot late in the clock, and then never hit the rim, though it was rebounded on the offside by Hurd. And a timeout. We're just about to get things underway down in Norman. Wooden Award finalists Buddy Hield and the Sooners taking on KU at 2:30 Eastern on ESPN. It's a one-point game, though, in Stillwater. Night Eastern, it's college basketball's greatest rivalry, Duke versus ninth-ranked North Carolina from the Dean Dome. Wednesday Night Hoops is part of Rivalry Week presented by Wendy's. Also streams live on Watch ESPN and the ESPN app.
Listen, a lot of imperfections in college basketball this year, but I think Carolina's one of the more complete teams. They have experience, good guard play, and Marcus Page, who's shooting the ball, Mark, better from behind a three-point line. Kennedy Meeks, Bryce Johnson inside. If they could ever start defending consistently, this is a team, I think, Carolina, that can make a run to the Final Four in Houston.
Yeah, the tournament should be wide open. I can't argue with anybody who picks North Carolina or Maryland or Oklahoma or a lot of different teams.
I'll tell you, the selection committee picking the 3 through 8 seeds are going to be pulling their hair out.
The lob to Owundu, who's fouled. Kansas and Oklahoma, by the way, right now going into today, Lunardi has his one seeds.
See, that's a back screen, and I'll tell you, the guy that's responsible for that, Mitchell Solomon, needs the help on that back screen lob. Great play coming out of the timeout by Bruce Weber.
Wandu hits the first.
The guy guarding the screener is responsible for the basket on a back screen.
There's Lunardi going into today. Had OU and Kansas as one seeds. West Virginia 3, Iowa State 4, Texas 5, and Baylor 6.
And we got Kansas State under consideration like we talked about. They're 10 losses. All the teams in the top 25, 7 of those 10 losses, the teams in the top 15.
Well, Kansas State, thanks to the free throws, has taken the lead for the first time today. Jumper short from Hammonds and a Hurd rebound. It's been a long climb for K-State. They were down by as many as 12. That was at about midway through the first half.
Well, Kansas State, not a great shooting team, but this is a team that knows what their strengths are, and they usually play to them. But turnovers hurting them in this one this afternoon.
That traveled their 14th turnover.
Chris Lowry right there on Bruce Weber's left. One of the great young coaches in the country. Was at Southern Illinois, twice Missouri Valley Coach of the Year, 3 NCAA tournaments. Lowry took him to the Sweet 16 that one year, and was a great player at Southern Illinois, a great addition to Bruce Weber's coaching staff.
Hey, Chris Lowry, you mentioned SIU was there 2004 to 2012, and the success he had, could have probably parlayed that. It's a pretty good coaching job, but was loyal to SIU.
Well, there's some athletic directors need to keep their eye back on him, because he's one of the great coaches in the country. Mark, I did a clinic with him in Saloniki, Greece, 2 summers ago, and people just riveted to what he had to say at the clinic.
Three is on the way and off the back rim from Newberry. Edwards brings it out for K-State. I'm just impressed you couldn't say Saloniki.
Well, listen, I was there for 10 days, and it took me 12 to figure out the pronunciation.
Kansas State with the ball and a one-point lead. 9 minutes to go. Six to shoot. Wade does so, and it's splashed down. First bucket of the game for Dean Wade.
Well, that's one of the things the big guy can do. He could stretch the defense with his shooting. Has a little ruggedness about him. But the freshman, Mr. Basketball in Kansas a year ago, sometimes, Mark, he puts a little too much pressure on himself. But let's see if that shot gets him going.
8-0 run for the Cats. Griffin driving, bumped by Irvin. Griffin again getting the start without Juwan Evans for Oklahoma State. There's Chris Lowry.
Yeah, terrific run at Southern Illinois. And like we said, two-time Missouri Valley Coach of the Year. Led him to the Sweet 16 in 2007. A terrific defensive mind. And like I was saying, Mark, we spoke at a clinic in Saloniki, Greece, two summers ago. And coaches from Turkey, Italy, Greece. First time Chris and I ever spoke where we had an interpreter at the clinic. But he'll get another shot, and deservedly so, to be a head coach at the Division I level.
You didn't have to learn Greece.
No.
Greek.
I got no chance at doing that.
By the way, the foul on Irvin, his fourth. So he's the first on either side to four fouls. Brown picked up the dribble, but was able to find Justin Edwards.
Now you want to execute your way through trouble instead of turning it over like they did right there. See, that, I'm sorry, Mark, that was another downing of the ball screen by Oklahoma State on the side.
Underneath, Salomon blocked away, though, staying with Oklahoma State. Timeout, under 8 minutes to go.
Well, you need help on the backside. It's provided right here. The shot fake, great rotation by Joe Burton.
On cue, Eddie Sutton being introduced to the crowd back at Gallagher-Iba Arena. Six different schools winning 806 total games. Took Oklahoma State to the Final Four in 95 and 04. Now he is one of the finalists for the Basketball Hall of Fame.
And deservedly so. Two-time Coach of the Year, Conference Coach of the Year, eight times. We almost played him in 2004. I was at Wake Forest. Chris Paul was a freshman. We were beaten in the Sweet 16 game that year by St. Joe's when they were undefeated, and then Oklahoma State took down St. Joe's in what was the Meadowlands in New Jersey and went on to the Final Four that season.
OSU right now in a drought. Missed 12 of their last 13 from the field. Make it 13 to 15, but then an emphatic flush by Mitchell Salomon.
Got to get easy baskets when you're struggling to score. One is off the fast break. The second way to get an easy basket is second shot opportunities.
7.5 minutes to go. K-State has trailed through most of this game. Wade reach in there by Joe Burton.
Mark, with the way they're calling fouls this year, any contact when you're driven, I think both of these teams need to look to drive the ball more. Put foul pressure on the defense.
That's all about freedom of movement, isn't it?
Yeah, it really is. And put pressure on them by driving the ball.
Was with the freedom of movement. Points are up. Possessions are up. In general, do you think it's been good for the game? Do you know?
I really have. But as I talk to coaches throughout, they're just a little concerned with when you have absolutes, and some officials told me this too, Mark, absolutes being one hand automatic foul, two hands automatic foul, stiff arm bar on the perimeter. A couple officials have told me that when it's an absolute, they're not sure if even they really like it. Like if I give you a stiff arm here and Gronkowski gives you a stiff arm, it's a little bit of a difference.
Turnover from K-State. Open three, good! That one from Burton. Right now, you got Oklahoma State shooting better from three-point range than two-point range. And the big reason, Dino, is they're getting open looks out there beyond the arc.
They really are. And one of the reasons is, too, Mark, is the transition defense by Kansas State not finding guys quickly enough.
Loose ball. A 1-2 diving after it. He punched it away, and it's picked up by Wade. And K-State able to keep possession, but seven on the shot clock. Brown scores.
I like it. I like taking the ball to the basket a little more like Barry Brown did right there.
Solomon's on the bench with four fouls for Oklahoma State. He's the first Cowboy to four.
When you have games like this, the guys that come up with those 50-50 balls like we saw on the floor make a difference.
Brown to Edwards from a tough angle off DJ Johnson, but the foul is going to be whistled against Oklahoma State.
Well, poor transition defense by Kansas State. When you're getting back, you should hear voices. You should see guys pointing so you know what you have. And I really like this right here. I think both of these teams need to drive the ball to the basket a little bit more.
Kansas State has been perfect from the line today. Here comes Stephen Hurt back in, replacing DJ Johnson.
And that's the other reason to drive the ball, Mark. You're perfect from the free throw line. Let's put foul pressure on the defense.
Edwards right near his season average. DJ Johnson, by the way, 24 minutes after playing 32 minutes in the game against Baylor the other night. But Kansas State right now, they were down 12 in the first half. They're up 2 with 6:04 to play in Stillwater. Or before the game. Right now, the earth's shaking with K-State coming back from 12 down, up to 6:04 to go. We saw Barry Brown, that nice drive to the rim, and you'd like to see a little bit more of this.
I really do, Mark. I think we need to put the ball on the floor a little bit more, but what really helps guys take the ball to the basket is when you have good spacing, and spacing a lot is attributed to a four-man that can stretch the floor for you. Like when you're Kansas State, when Dean Wade's in the game, he provides some three-point shooting, so he provides stretching the defense where you can take the ball to the basket. But K-State perfect from the line. Let's continue to try to get there from an offensive perspective.
Oklahoma State down two with possession and 6 minutes to go.
And this is the story for Oklahoma State. Travis Ford has had these guys in every game without his two best players coming down the stretch. But he can't win it for them. They got to execute their way to a win on the offensive side of the ball.
Burton kicking it to the big man, Allen. Tied up. Possession arrow, Wildcats.
Boy, the big guy has to be stronger with the basketball in there. There's no way some little guard is going to tie him up. And that's just what Justin Edwards did. Big fella, play like you're 7 foot. Pivot through there, take it up there strong. Got to play through contact when you're that big.
Threading the pass to Hurt, the reach and the foul. Well, speaking of foul issues, Solomon with four for Oklahoma State. Griffin has three. For K-State, you have Irvin with four, but he's the only one in real foul issue with the Wildcats. Returning is Leighton Hammonds. And the team fouls, look at the discrepancy right now in the second half.
Absolutely. When you see Anthony Allen coming out, now this guy right here is a rim protector, but you can't allow Stephen Hurt, Mark, to catch the ball where he caught it. Heck, he was in the ladies' restricted area arc. He was so deep, you can't allow him to catch the ball that deep.
First free throw miss of the game by K-State. They were 12 for their first 12, but the front end missed by Hurt. Oklahoma State's the team that came in shooting the best from the line in the Big 12 at 75%, but they're only 2 of 6 from the line today.
Oklahoma State going into a lot of short clock possessions.
Kick to the corner. Hammonds miss! An aggressive Newberry able to come up with the board and is fouled underneath.
Boy, what a bulldog that kid is right there. 6'2", 185. He plays like he's 6'7", 220. Strong, athletic. He's the biggest X factor for this team right now, and he's making his presence felt under 5 minutes in this game.
Third foul against Dean Wade.
One percent from the free throw line, Jeff Newberry coming into this one.
Well, Markell Brown was a teammate of Marcus Smart here at Oklahoma State. Markell Brown now in the NBA with Brooklyn, and of course Marcus Smart with the Celtics.
How about that backcourt? You got two NBA guys in your backcourt, and that's a job Travis Ford did with his recruiting to Stillwater.
Tied up, under 5 minutes to go.
And we're seeing zone out of Oklahoma State for the first time this afternoon.
Long arms. Shine almost got the steal. Three missed by Edwards. Tipped by Wade, but into the hands of Griffin.
Now, Kansas State continues to see zone as we had a wide open three. Boy.
But there for the putback, Hammonds.
What I was about to say, Mark, Kansas State has to make sure, just because Oklahoma State is in zone, that they don't settle for just jump shots.
Oklahoma State has reclaimed the lead. We're coming up on the four-minute mark. Johnson threatened it to Wade, but then he collided with the defender, got it back, and then it's tied up. And it's Oklahoma State ball.
Well, when you see zone, one of the things you want to do is get the ball to the short corner or to the high post. They got it to the short corner. D. Wade needs to be a little stronger with the ball right there. It's tough, and it's a good call by Travis Ford. Two zone possessions, two stops for Oklahoma State against the young Kansas State team.
Burt drives. Second may go against Brown, and we come to a timeout.
Well, long shots equal long rebounds, and you're seeing Hammonds right here. Run this thing down on the miss by Newberry. Stayed right with it. Used the glass for the finish.
At Duke Carolina from the Deep Dome. Well, 3:44 remaining at Stillwater. Oklahoma State ball, they're up two. Bruce Weber's team come from 12 down, taking a four-point lead at one point. Burton at the line for Oklahoma State.
And you know what, Mark? You know Bruce Weber spent the whole time out talking about his zone offense. So it'll be interesting to see if Travis Ford, just for a possession, goes back to man-to-man. But when you see zone, when you're 5-on-5, you want to go short corner, mid-post. You want to drive gaps against the zone, or you want to screen the zone. But you got to make sure Oklahoma State, and they do stay zone, they're not in charge of Kansas State's shot selection. In other words, don't just settle for jump shots.
Wade from the left elbow, looking. Went for DJ Johnson, who was trying to rip it back away from Burton.
Kansas State has the arrow, but you saw what Bruce Weber tried to do. Get the ball in the middle of the zone to Dean Wade. They just weren't able to connect on the high-low pass. Eight on the shot clock.
A one-do. Brown, a three. Got it! Huge three for K-State freshman Barry Brown.
And on the baseline out of bounds with 8 seconds to go, Oklahoma State went back to man. Kansas State took advantage of it.
Second three of the game for Barry Brown, who has 10 points.
Boy, some guys can have the ball in their hands with a short clock. Some can't. This is a guy that you need to get the ball to, and Barry Brown delivers for K-State.
A lot of composure for a young player.
Really, and he's a guy that's come in and struggled his last two games. 0 for 7 from threes. 6 for 21 in his last two from the field against Oklahoma and Baylor, but big shot right there for K-State on the road from Barry Brown.
Two in double figures for K-State. Edwards with a dozen. We mentioned Brown now at 10. One in double figures scoring for Oklahoma State. That Leighton Hammonds with 13 points, so Newberry knocking on the door with 9. No big foul issues on either side. K-State does have Urban with 4. And Solomon does have 4 for Oklahoma State as well.
And Mark, when you're coaching in tough situations like this, and both of these teams, Kansas State very young, Oklahoma State with so many guys injured, as a coach, your words are so important. And the four most important words you could tell a player or a team is, I believe in you. And so that's what these guys got to do, these two coaches, and being positive with their teams when they're struggling in a year like they're having right now.
Oklahoma State 11-13 overall, 2-9 in conference. K-State 14-10, 3-8 in conference. You know, K-State's a team. They have Kansas and Texas coming up at home in Manhattan. K-State still has a chance to make the NCAA tournament. They think things fall their way.
There's no question they beat the number one team in the country. Their losses, we mentioned already, all 10 of them against top 25 teams. When you look at the schedule like that and you go, wow, Kansas, tough teams, you want that because those open doors for you for inclusion into the field.
Yeah, it's certainly not going to be easy.
No.
But it's laid out for them.
But it gives you an opportunity to get in. You're playing low RPI teams. Then you have no chance to get into the field. They switch the ball screen.
Tough shot from Tyree Griffin.
Dean Wade having a tough time with the switch on Tyree Griffin right there.
First bucket of the game for Griffin, who has a couple of points from the line to total four. But Oklahoma State up one, under 2.5 minutes to play. Wade right at the rim. K-State by one.
Wow, terrific baseline penetration, and Awandu finds Wade diving from the elbow down the lane. Really good zone offense.
Burton got it to fall. Count it, and one.
And it looks like the official pointed to the restricted area arc right there, because no question he was a secondary defender. Let's see if he was in the arc. Boy, it looks like he's out of the arc. Now, Mark, if your heels, believe it or not, aren't touching the line but are above the line, you're still considered in, but let's see right here.
I think he was out of the arc.
I agree with that. But the official did point, which is the signal for he's in the arc. And I don't think that was the case.
Well, a big decision as it turns into a three-point play for Oklahoma State, who brings Solomon back with four fouls and gives Burton a seat. Clock starts when it's picked up by Brown.
And Travis Ford goes back to man-to-man. Throw it in there.
Wade gave a look to Johnson, but back out. Now Johnson looking to set the screen, not used by Edwards. 10 to shoot. Wade got it. Back-to-back buckets for Wade the last two sequences for the Cats.
And what a nice take. Played through contact and able to finish at the rim. And I love how he used the backboard to cushion the shot.
Tied at 50. A minute and a half to play. Blocked by Wade.
Big impact by Dean Wade on both sides of the ball. Dwayne Wade,
Playing a little bit like
Dean Wade. But not Dwayne, not the guy for Miami. Yeah. Last couple possessions, he looked like him.
Awandu ran into Solomon. And Solomon holds his ground, and it's over to Oklahoma State. Well, the travel, the 18th K-State turnover. Timeout called. Oklahoma State will have one left.
This is when you tell your guys, fellas, all that shell drill we did on the defensive end of the floor in preseason and throughout the season, here is where it has to manifest itself with a minute and 13 to go on the road. And that's what Bruce Weber's telling his guys.
Well, coming up after tonight's big matchup between 24th-ranked Texas and 14th-ranked Iowa State, stick around for SportsCenter at night with Max and the coach. They'll have all the college hoop highlights, including the other mega matchup in the Big 12 between Kansas and Oklahoma, and highlights from the NBA skills, three-point, and slam dunk competition. SportsCenter at night tonight after college hoops on ESPN and streaming live on Watch ESPN and the ESPN app. Well, I don't know if it's Dwayne Wade, but Dean Wade kind of playing like him.
Well, he is. He dives down from the middle of the zone, which is a great look and a great finish. And then D. Wade, playing physical through contact, uses the board as a cushion. And Mark, down the other end, he gets a block and helps get a stop for K-State as we're knotted at 50 in this one.
Really, the last four or five trips down the floor for K-State, Dino, you're looking at Brown and Wade, both two true freshmen for K-State maturing before our eyes.
And that's what Bruce Weber has, one of the youngest teams in the country right now, and puts him on the bench quick for this defensive possession.
Fewest points scored in a game this year by K-State is 55. Fewest by Oklahoma State in a game is 56. Either one of those marks may win this game today. As we take a look at the composition of the K-State roster. Eight either freshmen or sophomores, seven of those freshmen.
Wow, 10 newcomers, third most, highest in Division I. So with Wade with four fouls right now, Bruce Weber playing the offense-defense situation for K-State. So Wade on the bench right now with four fouls.
And Brown all tied up. Picks up his third. So Urban and Wade with four for Kansas State. Now Brown at three. Solomon's still the only Oklahoma State player with four fouls.
Mark, a big NBA thing, as we know, teams in the league like to go two for one. K-State could do that. And as a coach, you ask yourself, do we want to get a quick one knowing we'll get a second one back? Or do we want to get a good shot? But if they would decide, they'd have to take it with probably 45 on the game clock, Kansas State, which would assure themselves of another possession as we see Dean Wade come in as K-State will go to offense after the free throw.
Griffin in a big front end. And connects on both. Two-point lead. Oklahoma State, 62 seconds to go in regulation.
Less than 1 minute to play.
The one who finds shots and was able to get past and elude Solomon. And Oklahoma State is going to use their final timeout.
What a great possession by Kansas State. Going inside, scoring right at the rim. Bruce Weber couldn't have asked for more than that right there. Like I said, one of the ways when you're fronting the post to feed the post is from the top. Awandu, nice seal inside by the big fella, but a nice delivery by Wesley Awandu.
DJ Johnson now at 10 points, joining Brown with 10, Edwards with a dozen for K-State. We reset it. Possession arrow favors Oklahoma State. See the fouls. Both teams in the bonus. And K-State has two timeouts. Oklahoma State has burned all of theirs. Big possession for the Cowboys with 51 seconds to play on their home floor.
And Bruce Weber telling his guys, listen, let's make sure we give them one shot and one shot only.
And it's a three. In and out, missed by Burton.
And a really good look because Stephen Hurd had to help on the ball screen, which created the pass for the open look for Oklahoma State.
Well, there's about a 10 and a half second difference between the shot clock and game clock. So Kansas State will use a timeout with one remaining.
And you know what, Mark? I like what they did the last possession. They get the ball in Awandu's hands, who's their best player right now, the junior. And they post it up on the inside. So that's where I'd want to have the ball. I'd want to have it in Awandu's hands as we come down the stretch here.
14 and 10 overall, but all 10 of those losses this year have come to teams in the AP Top 25 poll. Yeah, you know, we've seen teams in past years in a really good Big 12, which certainly this is another year of that, Dino, go to the tournament with only 8 wins in conference play.
Well,
go 8-10.
When you have a strength of schedule of 8, you know, one of the best top 10 schedules in the country. And like you talked about earlier, Mark, with the games that they have upcoming with Kansas and Iowa State, they have opportunities to play themselves into the field.
And Kansas State, after this game, they go to TCU on Tuesday, but then they come home next Saturday against Kansas. Then the following Monday, take on Texas. Then they go to Iowa State, TCU, Texas Tech. You know, if they can navigate the first four games of those six remaining, they've got a shot to make the NCAA tournament.
They might be able to go 3-3 in these, but the big three would be Kansas, Texas, Iowa State. If you could get them, and I'll tell you what, I think if you could get two of those games and somehow come out of that group right there with four wins or even three wins, if they could win two of those, I think they really they make a mark for themselves of being in the field.
You're saying win two of the KU Texas
Iowa
State trifecta.
Iowa State once, yes.
All right, here we go. Tied up at 52. Brown. That's a two. Hammonds had it. Actually, Newberry taken away by Johnson out of bounds. Who's possession?
They could go to the monitor to review this, and they absolutely should to see who the ball went off of.
They looked at one another. Give it to K-State, but as Dino mentioned, they're going to have the opportunity to look at this, which they will. Because a huge call here with just over 11 seconds to go.
Jump shot, and boy, what a hustle play by DJ Johnson. On the floor.
Wow, tough to tell from there.
Yeah, tough to tell from that angle.
I think it was off Solomon's hand.
I'm going to agree with you. I think Mitchell Solomon pushed the ball out of bounds with his right hand.
Johnson has it, and then you see the right hand of Solomon.
I agree with you, Mark. I think it's going to be K-State ball on the baseline.
With 11.2 seconds left.
So if you're Kansas State and you're Bruce Weber, until you find out definitively, you're giving them an OB play, trying to get the ball in your best player's hands, or Wandu, and you're saying, if we do have it, if it's our ball, let's take this shot with 5 seconds to go or nearby. That way we have a chance for a second shot opportunity.
Oklahoma State led by as many as 12 midway through the first half.
It is Kansas State ball, Mark.
Oklahoma State had a 5-point lead at halftime. Kansas State did not take the first lead until well into the second half. They have a shot here to win it in regulation.
Well, Wesley Owandu taking it out. Watch for them to go right back to him.
And they'll use their last timeout to avoid the 5-second call.
See, and that's why you have the guy that can make good decisions, taking the ball out for you, Wesley Owandu. He has the wherewithal under pressure to call timeout so they don't get a 5-count. We would keep track of what we would call, almost like in football, special situations. Our baseline out of bounds were special situations. And after the game, we chart how many times we scored on baseline out of bounds, how many times our opponents scored on baseline out of bounds. And a lot of times, those were the differences in games. These little situations right here go a long way to defining wins and losses on the season.
Coming up after this game, we'll take you to Houston, UCF and Houston. Here's Brown. Brown stumbling, throws it up. Tip. Would it count? Yes! Was it in time? Was it in time? Is it a game winner for Newberry? Watching it in real time, Dino, I thought it was a hair late. But we'll see.
We're going to see right here. But again, this whole game has been a grind out. And Oklahoma State, if it does come down, it's the loose ball that makes the difference.
Newberry.
Yeah, it's still in his hand, yep. Mark. It is. You called it.
It is not a game winner for Newberry. The officials will take a look at that, and we're going to go to overtime. Just an eyelash away from being a game winner for Jeff Newberry.
Boy, he shot it too. It was no throw, but I agree. I think they're going to come to the conclusion. It was still in his hand when the light went off.
Mike Stewart, Darren George, Brent Smith, our officiating crew, taking a look. And they wave it off.
Yeah, it's absolutely in his hands. You know what, Mark? There's psychology involved now for both of these coaches. I was very lucky in 2010. We had 5 overtime games, and we were 5-0 in those games. And I'd come to the bench right now, like these coaches are, and I'm saying, fellas, is this great or what? We get to play 5 more minutes of basketball. What's better than that right now?
Don't think about the fact you were about a tenth of a second away from a crazy walk-off shot from Jeff Newberry.
You got to have a little Dr. Phil in you right now. Fellas, is this great? We're in the gym. Where else can we be right now on a Saturday afternoon? This is great. We get to play five more minutes.
Both teams have been into overtime one previous time this year, but fallen. And Oklahoma State and Kansas State with another 5 minutes in Stillwater. Well, 13 points for Hammonds to lead OU. Edwards with a dozen, Brown and Johnson each with 10 for K-State as we head to overtime. And Pistol Pete's like, oh, missed it by that much.
Not happy with that one. But the absolute right call, as we saw. We monitor review. We're seeing how important that is. The ball on the baseline, they gave it back to, and it was the right call, to Kansas State. The ball went off to Mitchell Solomon, and then we got a ruling in the correct one again on the late shot by Jeff Newberry.
And I know replay isn't perfect. We saw that the other night with the Boise State game.
Yeah, absolutely.
But for the most part, how can you not like instant replay? We just saw two instances right here where they get it right.
It's made our game better. And Leon Rice, I read this morning, says he wants to win. He says, right, give us the win, but that's not going to happen. What we're talking about, of course, is the late shot by Boise State that the officials went with a stopwatch to the monitor. It was a little off with the technology today, and they felt like the conference said the shot should have counted. It didn't, and then Boise State lost, but nothing you can do about that right now.
For those of you tuning in for UCF at Houston, that's getting underway now on the ESPN app. And we will take you there to Houston as soon as we are finished in Stillwater. But it's overtime between the Cats and the Pokes.
Short clock again, and the ball with Tyree Griffin.
Hammonds. Back rim miss with the long rebound to Griffin.
Long shots, long rebounds. The Kansas State guards got to run those down.
Slight rebound against Oklahoma State in the game, 31-28.
Flex action by Oklahoma State.
Three from the left corner, around and out, missed by Shine, who's hit a couple today.
A pretty good offensive possession by Oklahoma State.
A Wundu, relatively quiet game for him. 5 points on one of seven shooting. His one made field goal is a three. He's going to have to put it up. Never got it off in time anyway.
And really good ball screen defense again by Oklahoma State. Mark, when that big guy shows out there, especially from the top, you got to attack him. Attack his outside hip. Make that big guy move his feet. Kansas State, when it's like defenders are switching that screen on the block from the corner to the basket.
Got Wade playing with four fouls. You got Solomon playing with four for Oklahoma State. And the three this time hit by Shine from the right side.
And very unselfish. The one more to the corner, and you have a wide open shot from Oklahoma State.
Cowboys 9 of 29 in three-point shooting today now at 31%. K-State 6 of 16 at 38%.
More than half their attempts from behind the stripe.
Floated up by Brown. It's short. Crashing the board. Shine. So after the three, he collects the rebound.
Big defensive possession by Kansas State.
Already midway through overtime, just under 2.5 minutes to play. Three, Hammonds. A Wundu had the rebound, and then he was coming down. Collided with Shine. Tavares Shine. They may give that to Solomon. It is Solomon. That's his fifth, and that is number five on Mitchell Solomon, who fouls out for the seventh time this year in a game.
Yeah, he's been in foul trouble throughout the year, and a big loss for Oklahoma State right there. He's not shooting great from threes. Mark, only 1-for-10 from threes, Mitchell Solomon, on the year, but because he has the potential, he provides spacing for your offense.
He fouls out. 4 points, 2-of-4 shooting, 4 rebounds and assist. Owundu misses the front end.
Points hard to come by. You don't want to go down two possessions if you're Kansas State.
K-State hit their first 12 free throws of the game, but now they've missed their last two, both front ends.
See, this is a smart basketball team, Oklahoma State. Running the clock down. Long possessions on offense.
Griffin, a 17-footer. Johnson pulls down the rebound. Edwards looking for Johnson. But then a grab by Shine on Edwards.
I like Kansas State trying to push the ball. Points are so hard to come by. You've got to try to get something in transition. You just don't want to play 5-on-5.
Glad to have you with us in overtime. Along with former ACC head coach Dino Gaudio, I'm Mark Neely. We were tied at 52 after regulation, and that's three consecutive misses from the line. K-State after they hit their first 12. Bruce Weber saying, hey, here's the form.
And Edwards in the game 4-for-4 before that one from the free throw line. And you know Bruce is telling his guys, fellas, just keep defending. We'll break through here somehow, some way.
And he missed a second.
You know, you talk as a coach about offenses and defenses and rebounding. Sometimes, Mark, it just comes down to free throw shooting.
But they're still only down one possession. They can get a stop here with under a minute and a half to go.
Kansas State switched everything, and that's why you're seeing the big fella DJ Johnson on Tyree Griffin right now.
Griffin trying to go to work, kicks it to the corner. Burton, offensive rebound, and Shine's foul.
You ask yourself as a coach, do we switch it? Or do we like hedge hard? And it comes down to what beats you, the open shot or the mismatch? It's obviously the open shot, so Bruce Weber deciding to switch the ball screen.
They get number one Irvin on that reach in, so he picks up his fifth and fouls out. Four points for Irvin, who fouls out of a game for the first time this year. A transfer out of Connors State College in the state of Oklahoma.
Well, you still got ball handling with Barry Brown and Wesley Owundu for Kansas State.
Shine, a very good free throw shooter at 81% for the team. Oklahoma State, that came into today best in the conference in free throw shooting at 75%. But today, just 7 of 13, even after that make. Well, Tavares Shine has scored all 5 points in overtime for Oklahoma State. K-State yet to score in the extra period. Just over a minute to go. They're down five.
1 minute to play.
Wade, a long two, crashing the boards. Edwards. Johnson fouled after he came down with that rebound.
Offensive rebounding has been a big factor in this game. It's usually been on the Oklahoma State side. 14 second chance points for the Cowboys. Another an opportunity here for K-State to take advantage of an offensive rebound.
Two shots for DJ Johnson. He's 2-of-2 from the line today.
Mark, coaches run staggered doubles for their two guard, ball screens for their point guard. The easiest shot in basketball is the second shot. That's why we would always emphasize, make sure we're giving energy going to the offensive glass.
In and out. 1-of-2 for Johnson, and that's an important one because it keeps it a two-possession game for Oklahoma State.
And Kansas State extending their defense I think they play straight up right here and not foul. Plenty of time. You just need to stop with your K-State. Now again, they switch the ball screen.
Three from the left corner is short. Under 30 seconds to go. Out comes Edwards for K-State. Edwards driving, stumbles, lays it in. Timeout. K-State, 22 seconds left. They're down two here in the first overtime.
So Kansas State down two now. So Bruce Weber's going to extend his defense. Maybe you get one trap, and if you don't steal it, then you foul after that.
Edwards with the contact on Shine, but he finishes. It's not over in Stillwater. Well, it's been a defensive slugfest, but it's been entertaining in Stillwater today. With 22 seconds left in overtime, Oklahoma State have the ball in a two-point lead. A game that Oklahoma State led by as many as 12 midway through the first half. They led by five at the half. Let's take a look at our game recap. Bruce Weber getting his team fired up. Believe it or not, liked what he saw from Barry Brown, but a three at the buzzer at the end of regulation initially counted as good off the hands of Newberry, but it was late. But in the overtime, it's been Tavares Shine for Oklahoma State. He's hit a three from the corner. He has all five of their points. K-State's only down two, but they've missed four of their five free throw attempts here in the overtime.
That's been the difference in this game so far, down the stretch anyways. And again, Bruce Weber in the huddle, he'll extend his defense. Maybe you try to get a five count or a steal off the inbounds. If it does come in, let's go one trap. We don't have anything after that, but we got to foul and put these guys on the free throw line.
And again, Oklahoma State hasn't been great today from the line, 60% 9 of 15, but that really has been an aberration because they came in at 75% from the line on the year, number one in the Big 12 in free throw shooting. Well, Oklahoma, Kansas underway in Norman. West Virginia with a win today. Right now, Kansas early up nine in Norman. But in this game, K-State looking for their fourth conference win and Oklahoma State looking for their third.
So on the ball to put pressure on the passer.
Linda Newberry, who's an 81% free throw shooter, today has hit two of two from the line, and they foul with 21 seconds, 21 and a half to go.
Newberry comes in shooting 81 from the free throw line, and he's perfect today, Mark. Travis Ford, a great job on the inbounds play of getting the basketball to a guy that can go to the free throw line and knock him down.
Oklahoma State has a number of excellent free throw shooters, but if you could have Travis Ford pick the guy he wants at the line in this spot, it'd probably be Jeff Newberry.
Well, you know Bruce Weber gave his guys a couple options. Fellas, if we don't get the steal and we go down three, then this is what we're going to go wrong. If it's a four-point game, if this one goes in, if I'm him, I'm telling my guys, just drive the ball to the basket if it's a two-possession game.
Big front end hit by Newberry. He looks to make it a two-possession game. And does not. How does K-State play it here? Wondu kicks to Edwards. He's in the lane. A scoop shot. Doesn't fall. Johnson, no. Out of bounds. Off Oklahoma State with 9 seconds to go.
And Kansas State with no timeouts right now. So Bruce Weber trying to communicate to his guys what he wants on the out-of-bounds. And, Mark, everybody has in their package a three-point shot off a baseline out-of-bounds play. Boy, they're looking at it to see who it went off of, and it gives Bruce Weber a chance to draw something up with these guys. I think it went off Newberry.
Well, falling down, Hammonds.
Yes.
Oh, if he had just let that go, I think that was off K-State.
I think it might have went off of Newberry, but I think it's going to be K-State ball. And like we said, the review gives Bruce Weber an opportunity to draw something up here.
So 9 seconds left. You go for the three?
If it's me, I go for the three. Yeah. I'm going to run a play where we can get a good look, but I'm telling my guys, listen, if it's not there,
drive the ball, get in, and then we score, get in our prevent defense, try to shut out, but we got to foul immediately. Don't force an ill-advised three with a guy draped on you or you're standing at 24 feet away from the basket.
Okay, you look at the players who are going to be on the floor. One of the other elements, by the way, here is to see how much time should be left. Yeah, I think you're right. I think Newberry did touch that anyway.
Yeah, I think either way it went off of Oklahoma State. But they're going to probably put, what, 10 seconds up there, 10 and change?
Somewhere around there. And Edwards is a 28% three-point shooter. Brown, 32.
Now, Mark, if you're Oklahoma State, you know, up three, do you foul? Now,
good
here's
question.
The thing. You make that decision in October. That's when you make that decision. And you say, fellas, down three, if it gets to 6-7 seconds, we're going to go ahead and foul. But this guy's options right now, Travis Ford, we can foul up three, we can play our base defense, or we could switch all screens. But like I said, he made that decision back in October. Let's see what he does right here.
Put 10.2 on the clock. Again, we'll send you to Houston, UCF, and the Cougars when we're finished here.
A lot of perimeter guys on the floor for Oklahoma State. There's a switch. Another switch.
Wade hands off. Off top three. Missed by Edwards. Can he get another one off? He does. That's a miss. Hurt throws it up. Doesn't get that to fall. Three opportunities for K-State, but Oklahoma State wins it in overtime by three.
And Travis Ford decided we're going to switch all screens no matter who comes together. Good defensive possession by Oklahoma State. And Kansas State have a lot of looks right here. There's the first one. Second shot opportunity. Boy, a lot of this game came down to second shot opportunities, and Kansas State just couldn't finish at the end.
So a three-point win for Oklahoma State, 58-55. K-State drops to 3-9 in conference, and Oklahoma State improves to 3-9 in conference play, and the Pokes in their three-game losing skid. We're going to send you to Hawfines Pavilion in Houston, Texas, for UCF against Houston with Brett Dolan and Kevin Lehman here in just a few moments. That's going to take care of things. This vantage point for my partner, Dino Gaudio. I'm Mark Neely. Thanks for sharing this one with us. K-State falls in overtime to Oklahoma State by three, and so long.